Hi everyone and welcome back. And in this video we will try to understand the Redux library. Okay, here we are not talking about React, only Redux, how the actions, reducers and store works with Redux. Okay, so this can be easily understood by a simple Redux getting started example. Okay, Redux has a store. Through store we will dispatch action, action will go to reducer, reducer will return as the new state. Simple like this. So this is a reducer function. I have current state and action. Based on the action, I will be returning the new state. Store will be created with the help of create store method provided by Redux library, which I have imported. So I will be calling create store. I will get the store, and that store method will give us three methods: store.get state, store.subscribe and store.dispatch. So dispatch will do nothing, but it is actually creating action and sending this action to reducer. Store.subscribe is doing nothing, but it is listening to the changes happening in a particular state, right? So here we are using all these methods: store.get state, get current state, store.subscribe. Whenever the store is getting changed, store is nothing but this state. We have a state which is initialized with 0, it can be 1, 2, increment, decrement will happen. So whenever the change happens, subscribe will call and we will get the updated state using subscribe method. So it's all about Redux. We are just using Redux library and we created a store. Once the store is created, we can do two things: store.subscribe, store.get state, store.dispatch. Store.dispatch, here we can dispatch these multiple actions: increment, decrement, update, delete. These actions are going to the reducer. Reducer will return the new state. That state will be available in the store. Now, instead of this small state or small basic state, it can be anything like const initial state. Can be any big state where you have a like profile I have, which is an array, or you can say friends. This is an initial state. So your state is initialized with initial state and based on action.type. Okay, if action.type, consider here I'm writing its action.type is add friend. Right, what you will do is you are going to return a new state, right? So const new. So what you will do is you will create a copy, right? So your current state is, your initial state is this object, right? So what you can do is you need a new object and which has friends. Okay, this friends can be you can just create a copy of it. So what you can do is state.friends. So you first you created a copy. Now what you can do is new.push. You will be getting something in the action.payload. You directly push it and you return the new. It should be new object, because new keyword we can't use, it's reserved in JavaScript. So add friend, right? This is how, if there is a case is default, in default case what you do is return the new state, return the current state. Right, so now this is your initial state in the store. Now whenever there is an action coming as an add friend, so type is add friend, and in the payload I'm passing my name. Right, so what actually we are doing is we are triggering an action to this store, to this reducer, and we are passing payload. So action.payload we are pushing and we are returning the new state object without modifying the current one, right? Now this become the new state. So now when you click, when you trigger this again, then it, your current state will have a TK Sharma. You keep adding this, okay? And the subscribe method is doing nothing, but it is just listening to the changes happening in the current state, right? So this is a typical Redux look like. You have a reducer, pure function. You will create these actions. Actions are nothing but a plain JavaScript object having type and payload. And you will have a store. which will be created with the help of reducers. So what we did is we passed a reducer function, we created a store. From the store you can dispatch, get current state, subscribe, all these things you can do. So this is an independent Redux library, how it works. Now we will integrate this independent Redux library to the React. So and there is a React Redux as a bridge library which will help us to integrate React components with the Redux store. Okay, thanks everyone.